Welcome to Unity Real Time Training Part 4. Now we are ready to evaluate your data. This is a list of topics covered in this video. Let's begin by looking at the bench review. Bench review is one of two review options. To access the bench review, select Review and then Bench Review. Select the data you want to review. Green bold color indicates you still have data to review. Black indicates all data has been reviewed. These selectors allow you to target specific data for review. In this case, we'll make a selection to include rule violations only. The Rules column shows the rule that was violated. The Status column indicates whether the point was accepted or rejected based on the rules. Removing the check mark next to Accept changes the status to Reject. Click here to add an action. Select the action, then click Apply and Close. The action is added to the entire run. When you are ready to mark your data as reviewed, choose the All Data option. Next, either click each checkbox or click the Reviewed checkbox, which selects everything. Then, click Save. The data is cleared from the bench review. Next, you have the option of submitting your data to the Instant QC program from the bench review. The Instant QC report is a peer group report located on the QCNet website. To enable this feature, select Tools and Setup. Select Data Review Transmission for Instant QC, then click OK. Notice that the Save button in the bench review now reads Save and Transmit. See video number 5 for further explanation of the Instant QC report. Another report you may find helpful is the Data Review Report. It shows the data points that have been reviewed in the bench or supervisor review. Select a test, then choose Reports and Data Review. Make selections in the dialog box, then click OK. You can print or save the report. Next, the supervisor's report shows data points that violate a rule or have an action or comment attached. Select a test, then choose Reports, Supervisory, and Supervisor's Report. Make selections in the dialog box. Click OK. The supervisor's report appears. Now let's take a look at a Levey-Jennings chart. Select a test. Then click the LJ button. Choose a date range for the data you want to see. The chart reloads with data. Details for the test display above the chart. Position the mouse over a point to view additional data. Click Options to make changes to the setup of your charts. Select the Graph Against tab. Selections here determine what is compared. In this case, we'll select the Consensus Group, Peer, and Cumulative. Click OK. The LJ chart reflects the changes. Our last topic for this video is the Data Analysis Grid. This feature provides a side-by-side comparison of statistics from the selected data groups. Here we can see Group A compared to B1. Let's take a look at how to make one. Select a lot, then select Analysis and Data Set Configuration. You can add or update a template. We'll leave Add selected. Enter a template name. Then, configure data set A. You can configure it for your lab's data or for the consensus group. Then, click the Data Set B tab. This is where you select how many additional data sets you want to compare to data set A. In this case, we'll configure B1. Here we set up B1 for the consensus group, including peer group and 6 months of data. Click Save. Click Close. Access the Data Analysis Grid again, choosing Analysis and Data Analysis Grid. The grid displays. Continue your training by viewing Part 5.